Gejo, are you there? Okay, Gejo is also there. Okay. Okay, so let's get started with this. So we are already discussing. Okay. There's some noise added in the background. Okay. Okay, let's get started. Since I don't have any inputs from any of you, so let me just share what I think about the paper. Okay. Yes, Priyanshu, DILR was difficult. Okay. Okay. But yes, Chandan, we will discuss the DILR cutoff also, and we'll try to see what the number could be. Okay. And Gitan, 34 in quant is good. LRDI cutoff 50. Are you crazy, Ketan? No, not possible. Okay. So, minimum attempts in LRDI. Okay. Okay. Let's get down to the section, to the paper. Quickly go through it, since all of you have looked at the paper. I don't think I need to spend too much time on this. Okay. I can just breeze through this one. Let me get my pen working. Yes. Okay, so VRC, similar to last year, I'll say marginally more difficult, because one, in VRC, I hope you notice that para summary. The marking scheme was +3, -1, that means it has not been considered as a non-MCQ or theta, it is a clicking on the answer. Okay, so this is not the, and I personally found the para jumble, the para summary and the odd statement a little difficult. But by and large, I would say similar to last year, especially RC was identical, not difficult at all. Okay, DILR, it was a horror story. A couple of days ago, I said that DILR can only become easier, but unfortunately, I've been proved wrong. DILR has become more difficult. Okay, no doubt about it, more difficult as compared to the last 3 years. Okay. Shubham thing, I see at close choices, yes, but they were not very close. One could easily eliminate. Okay. Okay, but yes, DILR was difficult, and quant was identical to CAT 15, I would say. Whatever was then CAT 2015 is what I saw out here. Hardly any geometry, very few questions of geometry, and many of them were mensuration. Primarily it was a DILR, primarily it was a arithmetic algebra paper. So that is the overall summary. So when I look at net, this has become marginally difficult. Marginally, not significantly. This has become significantly difficult, DILR, and this has become easier. So net, if I look at averaging out, overall it is similar to last year, maybe marginally more difficult, because the increase in quant, especially at the top end, increase in quant, as Gitan just mentioned, he did 34 out of 34 questions. It was not difficult to do 30 plus questions in quant. Okay. So, and when I look at quant last year good attempt was 22, 23. This year, I'll say a good attempt is about 27, 28. And going to 30 plus was not a problem at all. So, one can expect at least 5 extra attempts in quant at the top end. That means those of you who are 95 percentile plus in quant, could possibly have done 4-5 extra questions over what you normally do, or over what you would have done in CAT 2016. Okay, DILR is a case of -2 to -4 questions, so a reduction of 2 to 4 questions. DILR verbal maybe about -2. Okay, so overall net, it is likely to be a +2 questions. Okay, so this is where we are with respect to the overall paper. That the overall paper was similar, but yes, quant like CAT 15, DILR worse than what we have ever seen, and the verbal was by and large similar to last year's paper. Okay. Good attempts. This is looking at a score of about 99 percentile. Okay. Quantitative ability, I will still say this can be 30, 27, 28, and going up to 30 plus was not difficult. Gejo, are you there?
Yeah, ji, Pichari, hear me?
Yeah, ji, Joe, if, would you want to add something to the overall scheme of the paper?
I think that you have covered it, nothing more to add there. Okay. My sense was the same, especially with respect to BART. The BA was slightly higher of difficult level than last year. RC was slightly easier. So net it remained the same. And QA, of course, went easier than last year. But DILR obviously was, at least I felt it was difficult. It all now depends upon the kind of question set that eventually picked up and whether you got stuck and stuff. But I'm sure that the number of attempts will be lesser than last year on an average.
Yeah. So. Yeah. Great. So coming to the next slide, Gujijo, anything you want to add here?
Yeah, so here nothing much. I would still go with about quantitative ability about 25 to 28. I'm sure that those people who are good in math would have probably touched things beyond 30. But I think by and large, about 25 to 28 attempt with reasonable accuracy should be fine. And you're looking at this 12 to 14 attempt of data interpreted logical reasoning. That would have come from attempting multiple sets, not banking on three sets and doing everything. It'll largely be doing a couple of questions from here and there from across. I think anyone who crossed attempts like 18 or 20 would have probably picked two questions from here and there to reach that particular level. But by and large, I think that yes, if someone can hit two to three sets, then I think it's a fair estimate as to a good number of good attempts. Somebody was asking about what is a good attempt for 95 percentile on each of the section. I think we'll come to that, I think, GP, yeah?
Yeah, we'll come to that in a short while. Okay. So Gijo, summarize what I would have also said. So let's move to the next slide. Okay. Reading comprehension, I don't think this is something which we really need to spend time on. But by and large, yes, the length of the passage was roughly around 600 words, 600 words, and the three question passage was roughly 300-350 words. Okay. I personally did not find any passage difficult per se, but there was one passage which was about the species. I think the diversity of the species, etc. There I got stuck in a couple of questions, but by and large, I did not think there anywhere we had questions which were difficult or very, very confusing. In reading comprehension, okay. And parajumble, you know, I am pathetic when it comes to parajumble without choices. I spent some 5-7 minutes, decided it's not worth wasting my time, and went and did the other stuff. But here again, I did not find too big a problem. One question in parajumble and one question in summary, I was a little confusing for me. Okay, but I don't think these were significantly difficult. Data interpretation. Okay, we're talking about happiness index. In fact, the set which I've found the easiest is not here. Okay, let me just mention this one. I personally found this one to be doable. This one to be doable. The flight operation, the flight to 10 cities, and then it was a permutation combination data set by and large. Okay, matrix was doable, but that's a 5x5 matrix which was given of numbers. Okay. This was doable, but this is something which many people have left. Okay. That which many people have left as such, because it looked like something completely different. But once you went through this and you went through the choices, the matrix data was not difficult at all. This was the easiest one. This was again a very easy one. Now these are the two sets which I attempted first, and maybe that's why I'm saying they were easy. But by and large, that all they needed to you to do was spend your time and make the table. In this one, all you need to do was create a table. One table was already given of the children whose mothers had dropped out of school. So the table for the children whose mothers had not dropped out of school had to be created. Once you create that table, it was not difficult at all. Though after two questions, the information changed also, or some additional information was given. Okay, so these are the sets: burger fries, the survey one. These two sets were easy, okay. And as I said in the previous slide, okay, these two were easy, and this is something which people miss. So by and large, when I'm looking at, and in this happiness index, wala, In this happiness index wala, I could do two questions straight away. The other two questions needed some amount of work, so I did not go through them. So what Gejo said, this was a data or a paper in which you had to pick and choose questions from all sets. Possibly out of five sets, you pick up data and you do some 14, 15 questions rather than all three sets and all questions.
Okay, let me add something. This the data interpreted logical reasoning set would have tested the nerves of everyone. Mm. I think when you said nothing was obvious as to what was easy or difficult, that was the first problem. Mm. So it's a question of going with some kind of gut feel, and those of you who would have at least read every single set would have been the ones who picked up the easy ones. And And therefore, by and large, I believe that a majority of this student would not have done more than three sets. And a vast majority, I'm saying. So I'm picking the figure about 90% of the people, which is why the sense is that about 85% cutoff would probably hovering around doing two sets completely. This might take GP. And
two
then
set
there'll
complete,
be
these are two sets completely is 24 marks.
Yeah, that is too much. I think three threes.
I agree with you. Something like 16 to 18 marks would be 85%.
So that is where the cutoff starts, and then there will be a huge difference between the guys who will get into 95 or 99. And anywhere, if you have tried to cross about 18 attempts, something you are very safe. But even if you have attempted like something like a 10 questions, I don't think there is anything to lose. So please bear in mind that there is going to be scaling with respect to the second slot, which is currently happening, which we have no idea at this point in time, at least, as to how are the DILRs. Okay, so it could even be that the attempt of about 7-8 questions as compared to the second slot would be the same. But I think that's where it is now, GP.
You know, my gut feel is that in this section of DILRs, if you have a score of about 18, you will definitely be greater than 85%. Okay. It could be lower than 18 also, but 18 is something which I'm looking at, which means 6 questions. Okay. Answers of happiness index. Happiness index, we'll share those answers separately. But happiness index, I felt that the moment it said that two of them had 7 points, the only way one can get 7 points are 1, 2, 4. And then the graph told you exactly which are those, which one is 1, which one is 2, and which one is 4. Okay. So I don't remember the numbers as such, which of those two. Okay, so okay. Anushka, connect with Anushka. She's having some audio issues.
Yeah, so one more thing, GP, is that when people started saying that easy, I actually felt the easiest set was the matrix question. So my easy set is very different from these ones. because it's a question of what clicks at that point in time.
Right.
And I believe that those of you who would have kept blue, and those of you who did not lose school and take it on QA would have done a reasonably good job, because maybe 18 is probably all that is required to enough for an IIM.
Just to add, Gejo, this roots, which is the one which is you are going from A to N to B, or A to M to B. Now, this one you could do with the help of choices also. Okay, this was one set which you could do with the help of choices also. Child survey, I assure you, we'll not be able to share the answers now. We'll share them separately. But all I'm saying is there were sets which were available. But yes, as Gejo said, you had to be willing to spend time and get through them. Flight operations, by and large, a permutation combination data set. Happiness index, 2 out of 4 were definitely possible. The other 2 required you to do some extra work. Yeah, Gejo.
Somebody was asking a question on reading components. Let me, that was something I covered, but let me just give you the my sense of the questions of reading competition this year. I think this year the questions were by and large different from what we saw last year, because there was a fair mix of questions which asked in terms of the purpose of why the author wrote these questions, which required a better understanding. So there could be possible. So there were a mix of factual questions, but there were also questions which asked about why did the author wrote something. So it was a fair mix of questions which required both understanding. So, but given the fact that the passages were small, you could have spent time in terms of aramse reading those passages and getting these ones correct. So that was the shortness of, it was not a long passage at all. So in that sense, reading comprehension, plus the passage was not complicated, barring that probably one we talk about some, I think evolution or something, I think that was.
That's the one I also struggled a little with.
So that was a passage, when I first read the passage, I only could get one question out of it, and then had to then read again to figure out the rest.
And fortunately, the paper was not lengthy. In 50 minutes, I had done the paper except the prior jumbles. So 15 minutes for those 30 questions and then the 10 minutes for prior jumbles. So by and large, paper was not lengthy and I was not rushing through it, I was working at my pace. Okay. Yeah. So going back to DILR, Okay. So, this one, as I said earlier, two sets, these should have been attempted by everyone. Yes, they were required to put in some effort, but they were definitely doable. Okay, quant. I'm sure after DILR, this would have been a relief. So if DILR was a horror story, this was smooth sailing throughout. Your paper was here. This was the paper. Okay, this was the paper. Geometry mensuration. Half of these were mensuration actually. And again, choices were helpful. Quite a few questions, I just checked the choices and got the answer. And the interesting bit is, you could have done these questions even without using SQC. But if I have to pick up, I'll say this was similar to CAT 15. CAT 15 is what this paper looked like. That paper also had significantly large amount of these three sections. Couple of questions from odd maths as usual and few questions from, very few questions from geometry mensuration. And mensuration is the easier part for me, so I really felt that this would not be a difficult thing at all. As I said, some students have reported 34 questions out of 34 attempts. 34 attempts out of for all 34 questions. But last year, good attempt was 22-23. This is CAT 16. This year in CAT 17, to me, a good attempt will be about 27. So maybe plus 4 or plus 5 questions vis-a-vis last year is what I would look at in terms of the good attempts for. And remember, I'm looking at these attempts from a 99 percentile point of view. I'll share with you. Yeah, Gejo.
I think quite a few students asking about 90-95% each of the section. I think.
That's, yeah, Gejo, I'll just share in a minute.
Yeah, okay. Sure.
Okay. So expected percentile, slot 1 for 99 percentile, these are the kind of things we are looking at. Okay. And what this means in terms of marks, this is likely to be about a 155 to 160 kind of a thing, which is maybe 5 marks more than last year. Okay, so in terms of 99 percentile, this is what we would expect overall. Now, if I have to look at the earlier scores, lower scores, let me just share a whiteboard. Ayush, the single table, the survey set, there was only one set which had the table with numbers. That was the one. Yeah, Ishan, I'm just sharing. So, if I look at overall, okay, overall 99.5 percentile. Let me just share you. This is a first information kind of a thing. This could change because all of you are putting in data and if you go to currylauncher.com/CAT and check the percentile predictor, you will be able to get something from there also. Okay. So 90 percentile, I would say, would be about 115. In terms of overall score, okay, 95 maybe about 130, 99 about 155, okay. 155 to 160, that, let me put this way, 153 was last year, so maybe about 160, and 99.5 is likely to be about a 175. Okay, so this is what I would expect the overall scenario to be. Okay, now if I have to extrapolate this and give you it for the three sections, which is a verbal RC, DILR, and quant. Let me just give the 99th percentile first, because that's the number which I usually keep a track of. I will say 99th percentile for verbal is likely to be about 68 marks, 68, 70. Last year it was 74, expected to be down by about 2 questions, so 68 marks out here. Okay. In LRDI, I'll say about 36. Last year it was 43, 2 questions down, so that makes it about 36, 37. So 36 to 37. And in terms of quant, 99th percentile could be about 65 plus. I am adding 5 plus questions. Okay, around 65 plus. And remember, 99th percentile at the top end, people will be able to attempt 5 or 6 extra questions, but at the lower end, people will not be able to attempt 5 or 6 questions extra in quant. Okay. Gija, what is your view on the percentile estimate that I have given?
That's fair, yeah. So it's about 20-21 questions of verbal RC,
yeah,
and about 12 questions of DILR, 12 to 14, and yeah, about 22 questions of QA net correct. Yeah. I think that will be individually you'll start hitting 99, and then obviously anything about that. So
yeah, and if you get a 99 in each of the three, you will end up with a 99.5. Okay, and let me give the other number also, 90 percentile, because that is something which is also critical. I will say 90 percentile in verbal should be about 50 marks. Okay. In DILR, 90 percentile will be maybe about 20 to 22 marks. And quant, 90 percentile will be about 40 to 42. Okay. Yes, Ishan, that's what I'm saying for quant. I'm saying quant is similar to CAT 16, so on 65 odd, giving 99 percentile, I'm completely in agreement with that also. Chandrasekhar, just look at last year. Vis-a-vis last year the 99 percentile in verbal was at 74. Okay. So 85 percentile, okay, yes, 85 percentile is important because that becomes the sectional cutoff. So 85 percentile. If I look at DILR, first of all, the problem area for most of us, okay, I will put it at about 18, 16, 18, 17, so say let's say about 18 marks. 6 net correct answers will give you a DILR cutoff which you are looking for. Okay. 85 percentile in verbal is likely to be about 46 to 48. About 46, 47, could be as low as 45 also. So if you are around 45, you can definitely hope to clear this one. And when it comes to quant, okay, I will say the 85 percentile mark could be about again some like 36 to 38. Okay. Yeah. Okay, Uncle. Okay, Shristi, for 95 percentile, you can look at the mean of 90 and 99. Okay. Okay, so it becomes a little difficult to fine tune it so much, but do go to kailauncher.com/CAT. For the percentile predictor. Okay. You will have the percentile predictor here and you will be able to then get a clear estimate of what you are likely to be in the paper. Okay. At this point of time, we don't have all the questions. Some of you have shared the questions with us, but we don't have all the questions right now. So we will not be able to share the answers. Hopefully by tomorrow we will be able to. Vishwat, we will try to create the memory based paper because many of you have shared the questions. Okay, and Okay, it's asking, really don't remember the number of non-MCQ questions, those brackets. Okay, what I'll do is I'll have that included. The number of non-MCQ questions in quant was 7 and in DILR was 8. Okay, just like for the information of those of you who need more information, non-MCQ verbal was 7, quant 7, DILR 8. Okay. Okay. Okay, I hope this takes care. Gejo, anything you want to add?
Yeah. So for all those you asking those specific questions, I think the best sense would be that if you put your score or estimated score in the percentile predictor, it will get a fair estimate. What we are doing at this point in time is simply our own assessment in terms of how this paper was vis-a-vis the papers that you have seen in the past, and then making minor extrapolation with respect to that. And it will be very, very clear in the next couple of days. And I think for all of us, we have more tests to be taken. There is that now, there is IFT now. So quickly just forget about CAT at this point in time and focus on the rest. And I think that you might be feeling bad about one section here and there. Probably somebody is still worrying about DILR. The worry of DILR is every single human being's worry who took the CAT in the morning. Okay, so in that sense, my strong belief is that if you have just crossed about 8 attempts, you can be at least with reasonable accuracy, you should be at least, you can hope that you will clear the sectional cutoff. It will finally boil down to what you did with QA and verbal. 11 to 12 attempts should be good enough. That's what I'm saying, sir. I took the test now, so I missed the easiest test, if you ask me. Okay, one of the easiest tests. So my attempt was about 15, I think. I probably should have attempted 19. Okay, yeah. So the 170 is where you get 99%. So we'll get to know the slot 2 review, then we'll have a better sense. But the whole idea at this point in time, ladies and gentlemen, is okay, fine, we've taken the test, let's not cry about it too much, and let's focus on the next set, next test, next hurdle. Yeah,
essentially, I agree with Gejo. Of course, CAT is done, finish off with CAT, forget about CAT. Yeah, you may still want to go through the analysis, you'll want to look at the next slot, what is the reviews like, but by and large, now you need to shift your focus tomorrow. Maybe you need to go out and watch a film, go out for a party, or just sleep it off. But tomorrow onwards, please start focusing on these papers. Forget CAT. Whatever has happened, it has happened to everyone. DILR was atrocious, it was atrocious for everyone. Okay, So let's not worry about it. IFT GK, best place is your IFT compendium, which is on your website, in your SL. Please go through it. Every year we get some 6 to 8 or at times 10 to 12 questions from that. So please make sure you mug it up to the extent possible so that you are able to get those required 2-3 marks in that particular section so that you are safe. Okay. So we'll stop here and I'll just pause here for those of you who want to have an idea what the percentiles are likely to be. Okay. And can we get some answers? Yes, we'll try to get you the answers for DILR by tomorrow. What will the percentage for 12 attempts with math max song and for negative marks? Okay. So that's difficult to say. 33 marks, if you just try to extrapolate what I've written here, 33 marks is likely to be an 80 percentile in quant. Okay. So when I'm saying 85 percentile is likely to be about 35, 36, 37, 80 percentile would be. So for the other numbers, this one, or something below 85, my request is please extrapolate and verify it when we have the percentile predictor live. It should be live in a few in about half an hour or so, 6 o'clock latest. Okay, and it's 5:13, so I'm sure the second slot people will be trooping out by now. Yeah, Gejo.
Percentile for the slot one is live.
It's already okay. Live. Great.
Yeah. So they can put that there. I think the sense is. So Mayur, I think at this point in time, whether you are able to clear cutoff, anyone clear the cutoff, it's just a speculation now. We have to go with the belief that we'll clear the cutoff. Let's carry on with our story journey. We have to have tests. Let's leave. The worst thing that can happen is whatever is the burden. Don't carry burden. Like how we carry the burden of DLR to QA and messed up QA. Let's, if somebody did that, let's not do that. Don't carry the burden of CAT to other exams. A new challenge now. So please focus on the next set of tests. The memory based, everybody's asking memory based papers. Let's say that we are trying to get it organized. It all depends upon whether we'll be able to collate all the questions. And hopefully, if it happens, then it'll happen by tomorrow. Yeah. For all those of you. Yeah.
Right. Great. So, all the best. Thank you very much. And we'll share with you what happened in the slot 2 also. It's 5:14 by now. So, another 5 or 10 minutes, we'll start getting inputs. And then we'll update you on slot 2 also. Thank you very much. All the best.
All the best, ladies and gentlemen. All the best. Go rock the next day. God bless you.
110, 135. Just estimate based on the